Morning, guys. Morning, Gazza.
Morning.
Back at it again. Just been sat outside the dentist for about the last 15 minutes. We found out he's got a couple of old houses that we want to get permission for. But I got his number, so they said it was open between 9 and 1:30, but 9:15, still no one had turned up. So we'll give him a ring after anyway. Anyway, at the meantime, we've come to what's called Old Part of Town, the oldest part of Maryborough. And we're going to just have a little scope around this little park area. Just have a look, see what comes up. I think later on today, we're going to head down to the Speedway again because they've had a big 65th anniversary. So there was a big meet there. So that should be topped up and nice and ready for us to go back and have a swing later on. But up until then, we'll have a go around here and I'll show you the first target. Well, first diggable target is this little chap. It's a little bit dirty at the moment. I just see Disney Pixar, so I'll give it a spray and we'll see what comes up. Did I say Allison? Is that one out of Shrek? Let's have a look. I'll squirt it up and have a clean and let's have a look what we see. And so there he is. I'm not sure what he is, but I do know now. He's out of Toy Story 3. So, focus. There you go. Oh, Alien. Alien, Toy Story 3, Disney Pixar. And there he is. Regular in focus. It's a bit bad of this light. There he is. That's pretty cute. So that's the first find of the day. Well, I went for a little wander. Came back to find Gaz. He's only pulled up a little trip. A little late one. I think that's a little Lizzie. Can't quite tell the day. I think he said it was 1951, but 50% silver. Little thrift for Gaz. Nice early in the day, very well done. We've got this little place here that we've got permission for. It's a little scout hut. Been here before, but it always gets used, so. Before we head off to the Speedway, I think we're going to give it a little half an hour here and see if any goodies pop up our way. Anyway, obviously again, you'll be the first to know. Well, Gaz found a nice ring, a few coins, I found absolutely nothing. We're going to head up to the Speedway and hopefully see what all these people that turned up for the 65th anniversary have dropped for us there. So see you at the Speedway. Well, the Speedway was a bit of a bust. The gates were closed today, so we'll have to wait till another time, but we pulled up against this house here and we got permission to do this front garden. They got a big dog that they don't want to be let out, or kept in more like, so we can't do the back, but she said you can go ahead and do the front, so let's have another go here. Well, I'm on the board, at least. Yes. King George sixpence. What days? You see that? I think it's 1951. I can't even see if I've got it up the right way or not. No glasses again. Anyway, having a slow day, but yep, still got the silver. So yep, silver streak continues. Lovely jubbly. Well, next up is a penny. Looks like a Commonwealth penny. Don't think I'll get a date till it dries up a bit, because that side's pretty cruddy. But yep, pre-decimal. It's an early one, so more than likely be King George V. So yeah, nice. Pre-decimal's up. How about this one, Gaz's collection? Here's something different for you guys. I think it says 2016, so it's not really old. But it's pretty cool. Yeah, another one for your collection, mate. Well, while I've just popped up this little ring, oh, Gaz has just pulled himself a ram's head chilling up. So today it's turning out not to be bad at all. I don't think it's precious. It's ringing up 45, which is in the silver range, but it'll have to be clean and have a look at, but I think it's just a junker, to be honest. But you never know. Next up for me is this Rue half penny. Can't quite see the date. Gotta let it dry out and give it a rub a bit later on. I'll let you know what it is. But it'll be a Georgia Seeker, I reckon. I think you can vaguely just see him there. But just give him another little bit of a tickle. Yeah, popping out a little bit better. Yeah, I'll let it dry up and I'll give it a better rub and we'll see what date it is. And yep, little half penny. Isn't that strange? I rechecked the hole, as you're always supposed to, and found this little bugger in there. And that's the first nugget I found today. I've just said to Gaz, not even a nugget. And it was right in the same hole as a half penny. That's just incredible. But yeah, I'll recheck again, see if there's any more. Well, I can't remember if this is where we started. I think it was. You know me and Gaz, we're all over the place sometimes. Anyway, we're back again. We're going to finish up here, I reckon.
Yeah.
House was probably, I think, from the 1970s, but the ground could be a lot older. We're in a really old part of town. So we won't know what's here until we start having a look. We've introduced ourselves and she says, yeah, come in. So let's pop in there and see what we can find. I can't get away from them. If gold nuggets were toy cars, I'd be an absolute millionaire by now. Well, that one looks like it's got some age. I don't know if you can read that. I can't yet. I have to get a scrubber on it and have a look. That's been my day today. No coins. Plenty of toy cars, though. I just found this little tiny bullet. I don't know what calibre that will be. Probably, they say 2.2 and it sounds about the same. 2.2, that's what I'm saying. Really is a beautiful property though. I've got all this land. Mainly it was paddocks and stuff, she said. And the man subdivided it and sold them as lots. But it goes right the way back. Right the way down past that shipping container at the bottom there, there's a big dam. You know, if you ever want peace and quiet, this is a place where you're going to find it. It's absolutely beautiful out here. Well, that's it for me and Gaza. Been a beautiful day weather-wise. Finds for me have been a bit slim. Gaza's done all right. Nice to have Gaz. We'll do the obligatory roundup in the car and as usual. We'll head into Gaz's side. Come on then, Gaz. What you got?
A lot of junk. Don't know what that thing is. Yeah. Got a scout ring. It's only made of copper though.
Yeah, but that's beautiful.
Yeah, got $11 in goldies. Bit of small change. Couple of pennies. Little bird. Been meaning to put this one in. I found him at the Speedway a while ago.
Yeah.
Pair of sunnies.
He's been sitting on the dashboard for about a month.
Yeah. And prize is Ram's Head Shilling, 51.
Beautiful.
And a little thrip, 58.
Absolutely brilliant.
Yeah.
Not bad day for Gaz.
Yeah, pretty good.
Let's go over to my side. And
cleaned up on cars today. This little thing.
Which one are you pointing at?
That little one.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, that little one.
Your lead bus.
Yeah.
That's so cute. It might be a gaming piece or something, but...
Could be.
We was hoping it was silver, but I think it's just a lead one, but...
Yeah.
It's beautiful. Like I said, loads of toy cars today. I don't know which one's the oldest. That one looks like a Batman one, but he's yellow.
Yeah.
I might have a look at that one. Yep, okay, obligatory junk. Just the usual bits, odds and sods. I did get legendary sinkers, but I just didn't film them today. But there they are, they never fail to appear. That little bullet that I found turned into 5 bullets. Someone's been obviously shooting at a target down there or something. A little ring. I think it's just a little junker. Only one goldie for me today. That's it. Just one. That's not like me, but just didn't walk over them. Bunch of brown buggers. 10 cent coin. Yeah, very slim on coins, really. Commonwealth penny. A half penny. And my crowning jewel is my little Georgia 6 sixpence. So at least I did get some silver on the board. So, yeah, that's made my day worthwhile, just that little thing alone. So, anyway, that's us done. I'll be on site next week, guys, boy.
Yep. Harvey Bay next week.
Yeah, we'll see what we can do. Keep up with us because we fly around a lot, as you probably guessed. If you like the videos, can you please give us a like, subscribe, that kind of thing, or it all helps us out, actually, you know. So thanks for watching and see you again next week.
Until next week.
See you later, guys.
Do you want the light?
Yeah, that should be
that's
right.
Better.
Yeah. So was that yesterday, just done an hour. Excuse the road noise. I came across this. I just want guys to have a quick look at it. It's got a wave his machine over the top of it. It's got no markings as such, but it has every look like it's silver. And I've never seen anything like that before. So obviously it belonged to someone else, like a longer chain or something, but there's definitely a knight and a horse and a shield. And
could have been a belt.
I think it's too flimsy to be a belt, guys. Yeah, it hasn't got the weight.
No.
You know? Let's have a look what it rings up as. So we're just going across it with his Equinox 800.
22.
Jumpy or?
That's like, what's 50% silver?
Yeah, so it's not aluminium or.
No.
Try it again. It's jumping there, isn't it?
Yeah.
Let's try it with the legend. That's what it's saying on the legend. If you can let me know, it'd be greatly appreciated.
Here's a bit of tin. What's that? That's a bit of tin.
Yeah, that's 44. 43. That's 49. 48, yeah. 49. Anyway, if you can work this one out for us, if you've ever seen anything like that, try and get a better picture. I'd be greatly appreciated to know what that is, to be honest. Anyway, that's us done. Catch you next time. Thanks for watching. See you later.